Christian Solidarity Worldwide, together with World Evangelica Alliance, commenced India on its engagement with the UPR in May 2017. During the review, the government mentioned that it is committed to ensure a safe environment for human rights defenders. Yet the space for journalists, writers and other human rights defenders who question Hindu right-wing politics and dissent is quickly deteriorating. The recent murder of editor Gauri Lankesh, who spoke against blatant attacks on freedom of expression and minority rights, is indicative of wider crackdown on free speech and thought. During the UPR, several delegations urged India to retract its anti-conversion laws. The UN Special Rapporteurs on Freedom of Religion or Belief, who previously visited India, have been deeply concerned about the effects of these laws, which are procedurally flawed, providing the state with sweeping powers to interfere in the individual's choice of religion. Equally, these laws continue to be used to foster harassment, intimidation, and violence against religious minorities. We are deeply concerned by India's failure to review its anti-conversion laws, known as Freedom of Religion Acts, which are already fully enforceable in six states. For instance, Jharkhand state in northern India signed an anti-conversion bill into law on September 5th. The new law criminalizes conversion through allurement, force and fraud, but lacks a clear definition of these terms. Conviction carries a prison sentence up to 3 years and or a fine up to 50,000 rupees. We call on the government of India to implement its constitutional guarantees granting every citizen the right to profess and practice their religion or belief, and to ensure that the voice of dissent against oppression and injustice is protected.